Let's start with what we're seeing with the markets near all-time highs. You think they can go higher still. What's going to drive the markets from here?
Well, it's the same formula of two or three things that always drive markets: liquidity, valuation, and growth. And on all three of those spectrums, the underlying tone is pretty good. So it looks like Q1 will be the slowest growth rate for corporate earnings this year. It was about 4%. It looks like it's going to drift higher to the 6-8% range. While the Fed is tapering, the liquidity environment is still fairly positive. And valuations, while not cheap like they were a couple of years ago, are still pretty attractive.
But you are worried about some overvaluation, right? High yield REITs you think are looking expensive. So is that perhaps a harbinger of what's to come?
Well, I think it tells investors they should perhaps reposition their portfolios. I would add U.S. small cap, biotech. Big correction, but they still look reasonably expensive. Some of the more software-oriented tech names really got ahead of themselves in terms of valuation. So it just points to investors that they should tilt their portfolios toward cheaper asset classes.
So what's cheaper then?
Good question. So we like the energy play, so U.S. energy infrastructure, drillers, pipes, equipment makers. Global real estate companies, not REITs, so REITs where they have to pay out dividends. So yield-oriented investments like high yield and REITs look very expensive. Real estate operating companies that reinvest their profits in new projects look actually very attractive. And the big contrarian play we like is emerging market equities. Starting to look a little better over the last couple of months, but it's really been a year and a half that they've dramatically underperformed U.S. equities.